38 minutes after the hour. That young lady is Debbie Gibson, the song Staying Together. It's the new single from her debut album, Out of the Blue, released last year. That album has sold almost 3 million copies and produced 4 top 5 singles. Particularly incredible when you take into consideration the fact that Debbie is all of 18 years old, just graduated from high school. And clearly, she is out to get an early start on her career. Hello, thank you for taking time out of your career and joining us this morning.
No problem, my pleasure.
I gotta ask you, is it fun to make a video? It looked like fun.
It is. I think that's the whole point of it. I think that if you take videos as like, you know, a stuffy kind of thing and like get all serious about it, it defeats the purpose. I like it to just be like fun and just show, you know, my real personality.
Right. So. It sounds like you have, or looks like you have fun with your music as well.
Oh yeah, I do.
You started when you were 5 years old?
Actually, yeah, my mom and I were cleaning out my room and we found the first song that I wrote, the actual music for it. And that was a song called Make Sure You Know Your Classroom, and it was about starting kindergarten. So I guess, you know, just writing from experience, I guess.
Right.
And I started piano lessons at that time, and I got involved in a lot of theater and TV commercials and just anything I could really get into.
So it's really been, your life has been in the public mm-hmm. eye. None of this is really new to you then?
No, I mean, a lot of people say, you know, wow, what's it like being in on your first tour? And I say, well, you know, it's not totally new because, you know, I've been on stage since I was like 5, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
I read that your family converted the garage into a 12-track recording studio when you were 12 years old.
Mm-hmm. It started as a 4-track and, you know, just like a 4-track and a keyboard and a drum machine. And, you know, I'd work on my own demos in there. And now, you know, we've upgraded to like a 12-track and we'll be upgrading further, you know.
But you weren't just lip-syncing to songs on the radio. You were writing your own music
mm-hmm.
all through childhood.
Yeah, I probably the most satisfaction you could get is to really, like, you know, perform something you've written. Mm-hmm. I think that's the whole point of music, to keep bringing new songs into the world, you know. So, you know, I love writing. I write constantly.
We should make that clear that the songs on the Out of the Blue album are of your own creation, mm-hmm. composed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you're working on another album now and writing songs for that.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. We've almost completed 8 of the tracks, actually. And, you know, most of the songs are new. Probably the most frustrating thing as a writer is that I'm always writing new stuff. And, you know, it's like, in a way, I'm always like 2 years behind myself, because by the time the songs come out, you know, and
you're onto something else already.
I'm like way onto something else, you know, but that's why I'm going to go back into the studio. I'm going to put down a lot of the songs that I've written like this summer on tour mm-hmm. and, you know, then decide from there.
Is it a bit scary working on the second album after such a big first album, when you have that big entry?
Not really. You know, everybody talks about like the sophomore jinx, but I don't really feel that, because I feel like as a writer and you know, as a vocalist and everything, I've grown a lot since the first album.
Uh-huh.
So really, I can't wait for it to come out.
Really?
You know? Yeah.
Well, I understand that you live a kind of normal teenage life.
Mm-hmm.
How can that be? I mean, do you really have to do chores, wash dishes?
I really do, unfortunately. you know, a lot of my friends are at college now and stuff, but, you know, the friends that are home, you know, we just hang out when I'm home, and
I
talk on the phone until all hours of the night, you know.
Your last year in high school, weren't you somehow set apart from all the other girls?
Well, my true friends have remained my true friends, which is good, and I guess they can appreciate everything because they've kind of seen it from the beginning, and they realize how much work has gone into what I do, and,
okay.
you know, so they don't have those kinds of, like, jealousies and...
We're almost
questions.
Out of time, but I have to ask about one big jealousy. I hear you want to do a duet with George Michael. I think that would make lots of people jealous, including me.
I got to see him in concert last week. It was kind of like my big birthday present, and I met him, and I didn't bring up like a duet yet. I would love to work with him and Billy Joel. Those are the two people I really want to work with.
Great. Well, I wish you the best.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming in this morning.
Okay.
It is now.